mercies a new day on.
Good morning. Good morning. I'm Dr. Alicia Williams, and welcome to Life in Christ International Church. This is our Sunday school hour, and we are in our Sunday school lesson on this morning. Last week, the Lord ministered to us through our Sunday school lesson about the ordination of Aaron and his sons. And so this morning, we're continuing in our Sunday school hour the book of Leviticus. That's where we were at last Sunday. And this morning we're going to be in Leviticus 10. The title of our Sunday school lesson this morning is Death of Nadab and Abihu. They were Aaron's sons, two of Aaron's sons. And we'll read about that and learn about that in our Sunday school hour. Learn about the uncompromisingly holiness of God. And we'll learn about reverence and fear of God. And so this lesson this morning is very enriching. This lesson this morning, I think, is a gift from God, because it helps us to set our focus on how we are to approach God and how we are to approach the things of God. And so with that, let us open up with a word of prayer. And Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we love you. We thank you, Father, for the Sunday school hour. We thank you for Life in Christ International Church. Thank you, Father, for our youth ministry. And Father, you continue, Father, to anoint us and undergird us and encamp your angels about us, protect us, oh dear God, as we continue to build the walls of your church. We honor you for it now, oh God. And Father, we invite you into our Sunday school hour. May you, dear God, continue to have your way. Lord God, we lift up our Sunday school lesson this morning, death of Nadab and Abihu. Cause us, Lord God, to understand. Cause us to live a life that honors you and reverence you. All these things we bring before you now, God, and we love you, Lord, in Jesus' name. And so we are going into our Sunday school hour. So this is our roadmap for this morning. Our Sunday school hour, we already know the title of this Sunday school lesson is Death of Nadab and Abihu. The related scripture to Leviticus 10, the scripture that we'll be reading this morning, will be 1 Samuel chapter 2, verses 12 through 17, Joshua chapter 7, verses 1 through 20, Acts chapter 5, verses 1 through 11, and then Psalms 2, chapter 10 through, excuse me, Psalms chapter 2, verses 10 through 12. However, our lesson text, the story of the death of Nadab and Abihu, is coming from Leviticus chapter 10, and we're going to read verses 1 through 7. So that's what our Sunday school hour is going to cover this morning, our scripture reading of the Sunday school hour is going to cover this morning. Our lesson outline from our Sunday school book is the fire of the Lord, which will be covered in Leviticus 10, verses 1 through 3. It is our service to the Lord, which is covered in Leviticus chapter 10, verses 4 and 5. And then the call of the Lord, which is covered in Leviticus chapter 10, verses 6 through 7. And so this morning, this is our roadmap. We're going to go straight into reading our lesson text. We're going to read out of our Sunday school book to learn about the lesson outline, the fire of the Lord, our service to the Lord, and the call of the Lord. And then we're going to end our Sunday school lesson with questions about the lesson text. So make sure that we captured everything that the Lord wanted us to learn in this Sunday school hour. Then we'll briefly recap to make sure we were able to cover the lesson outline. We share our announcements for the upcoming week, and then we'll close in prayer. I do sincerely thank you all for being present this morning and for being a part of the Sunday school hour. This time in the Lord, this time away from 100 million other things we could be putting our mind and our heart and our souls to, is a blessing from the Lord, and it is enriching. It brings us to a greater place in God, greater understanding of who God is and how we are to walk and to live our life before the Lord. And so with that being said, our golden text for this morning is coming from Psalms chapter 2, verse 11, and it reads, "Serve the Lord with fear and rejoice with trembling." When we get into our lesson text this morning, we'll understand better. We'll understand fuller what Psalms 2:11 is sharing with us about serving the Lord with fear, rejoicing with trembling. We can read all day long, but it's important for us to search out and to walk out and find evidence, find witness in our souls, find witness in our life of what the Lord says over us and in us and through us and by us. And so that takes us into our scripture reading this morning. We already know our lesson outline, the fire of the Lord, Leviticus 10, verse 1 through 3. Our service to the Lord, Leviticus 10, verses 4 and 5. And finally, the call of the Lord, Leviticus 10, verses 6 and 7. I know this lesson this morning will be indeed enriching and empowering because of our genuine walk and relationship with the Lord. So with that being said, we're going to go ahead and get right into our scripture reading, starting at Leviticus chapter 10, verse 1. And this is the King James translation. I wanted to make sure I noted that. And verse 1 reads, "And Nadab and Abihu, the sons of Aaron, took either of them his censer and put fire therein, and put incense thereon, and offered strange fire before the Lord, which he commanded them not." Verse 2, "And there went out fire from the Lord and devoured them, and they died before the Lord. Then Moses said unto Aaron, This is it that the Lord spake, saying, I will be sanctified in them that come nigh me, and before all the people I will be glorified. And Aaron held his peace." Wow. So last week, the Lord ministered to us about the ordination of Aaron and his sons, Nadab and Abihu. And this week, we see that, as the scripture tells us, Nadab and Abihu offered strange fire before the Lord. And because of that strange fire, the Lord consumed them and devoured them by fire, and they died before the Lord. I love the dynamics of the study that the Lord is providing for us this morning. I love the tangibleness of God, even in this instance. But most important, I think, is the fact that there's a way that our minds, our hearts, and our souls are to come before the Lord. There's a preparation, and we'll read about it in our Sunday school lesson. There's a position, a place we come to when we come to the holiness of God, when we come into the holy things of the Lord. So let us read. The Sunday school book says, in last week's lesson, we studied the ordination of Aaron and his sons as priests of Israel, establishing the Aaronic priesthood under the Mosaic covenant. God showed his approval by accepting Aaron's first sacrifice, as recorded in Leviticus chapter 9. What happened next, however, became a national tragedy witnessed by many. Two of Aaron's four sons, who had just been ordained as priests, Nadab and Abihu, took their own censers, put incense in them, and offered strange or unauthorized fire to the Lord. And we read that in Leviticus 10:1. Their actions were not something God had commanded or mandated. What I want to do as we continue to read about this Sunday school lesson is identify nowadays some pastors or preachers that have fallen or have been consumed by the fire. And again, it's important that we grasp what our lesson is teaching us this morning about the fear of the Lord. The fear and reverence of God that causes us to rejoice and to tremble, as captured in our golden text. But when you look at the lives of those who have been consumed by the fire of the Lord that and have fallen, there's so many testimonies. And so I'm saying all that to say is that it is of great importance that we continue to keep our hand in God's hand. We, you know, the old school church always says, keep your hand in the master's hand. But nowadays, the enemy is raging. Nowadays, the enemy will try everything possible to steal our faith, to steal our walk and our relationship with the Lord. And we, as the Word of God calls us to do, have to stand there for. We have to stand against the wiles of the devil. Or else, we may end up as Nadab and Abihu. As the scripture says, went out fire from the Lord and devoured them, and they died before the Lord. And so, the Sunday school lesson, let's continue to read there. The strange fire offered by Nadab and Abihu apparently did not come from the altar where the burnt offering had been made. It had no association with atonement or sacrifice and was therefore profane to God, making it unacceptable. They tried to come to God their own way and were struck dead as a result. There is another gospel being preached, that we get to live any kind of way we want to live. This is not in the Sunday school lesson. This is me talking. There is another gospel, and we know what the Word of God tells us about those that preach another gospel. We get to live any way we want to live. We get to do anything that we want to do. We know that the Word of God says, we know that the Word of God tells us that gifts and callings are without repentance. Who wants to live a reprobate life? Who wants to live a life where we're lying to ourselves and we're not living before the Lord? Shame on anybody who encourages that. Shame on anybody that tries to present that or yoke other people with that. God is a holy God. The Word of God says, be ye holy, for I am holy. Don't turn a blind eye, but work as best you can to get it right before the Lord. That's why this lesson is enriching this morning. It's calling us to make a choice. Choose God. I say it all the time. Choose God. Every time, choose God. Whatever is enticing you, whatever is trying to take you and steal you away from the Lord. Let's continue reading this morning in this lesson. So it says, God spoke to Moses next, telling him to remind Aaron that he would be glorified before all the people had Nadab and Abihu not been punished. God's glory would have been diminished of all people. Those chosen to come near him as priests must come in a holy manner that reflected his own holiness. I want to reread that. I want you all to hear that this morning. Those chosen to come near him as priests must come in a holy manner that reflected his own holiness. After listening to Moses' words, Aaron remained silent. He did not dare to speak a word against the Lord in protest or dispute. That is a very, very important note. That's in Leviticus 10, verse 3. In the congregation of the Lord, in the presence of many, Aaron's two sons were devoured by fire. They died before the Lord, in front of the Lord, in front of the congregation, and in front of Aaron himself. And the scripture says Aaron held his peace. And our Sunday school lesson says, and I want to read this again. After listening to Moses' words, Aaron remained silent. He did not dare to speak a word against the Lord in a protest or dispute. When you have been in or have experienced the presence of God, when you know that, as the scripture says, your feet stand upon holy ground, by grace there is a level of discernment that rises up that allows you to know when to speak and when not to speak. Aaron was an example. His family was an example. And the essence of what the Lord is revealing to us is that he just lost his sons. They were just ordained as priests. And before the congregation, before all to see, they died before the Lord. And any parent know the love that they have for their child. You weep, you cry, you mourn, you hurt, you ache, you feel the loss. But in what the Lord is ministering on this morning about our position as high priest, our position as priest before the Lord, Aaron held his peace. He dared not speak against God. He dared not speak against the things of God. He held his peace, even in the loss of his two sons. Even in public ridicule, public chastisement, he held his peace. The Sunday school book says God had accepted Aaron's sacrifice with a fire of glory. But he condemned Aaron's sons with the fire of judgment. His judgment is always righteous, and God has every right to judge those who sin against him. So this morning we're learning about fire of glory, and we're learning about fire of judgment. It's up to you to choose where you will stand. In the midst of God's holiness, will you stand in the fire of glory, or will you stand in the fire of judgment? It's up to you to choose. I can't choose for you. Your parents can't choose. There's no one that can choose. You have to make the righteous decision before God. Not just once, but always. The only way to do that, you have to cultivate that. You have to undergird that. You have to live that. You have to walk in that. You have to eat, breathe, and sleep in that. So let's continue reading. Let's see what else our Sunday school lesson is sharing with us this morning. All right, Leviticus chapter 10, verses 4 and 5. Leviticus chapter 10, verse 4 reads, "And Moses called Mishael and Elzaphan, the sons of Uziel, the uncle of Aaron, and said unto them, Come near, carry your brethren away before the sanctuary out of the camp. Verse 5. So they went near and carried them in their coats out of the camp, and Moses, as Moses had said. So now we know that Aaron's two sons, Nadab and Abihu, offered strange fire. We know that the Lord allowed the fire to consume them, and they died before the Lord. We know that now that Aaron kept silent. We know that he held his peace. And now we see that Moses calls for Mishael, and he called for Elzaphan, the sons of Israel, Aaron's uncles, to carry the bodies out of the sanctuary, out of the camp. Let's see what our Sunday school lesson shares with us about these verses. The Sunday school book says, God often calls us to do things that are unappealing, unappreciated, unnoticed, and emotionally difficult. Service to the Lord is not only for preachers, pastors, deacons, and missionaries. Everyone who is a follower of Jesus Christ is called to serve him in whatever capacity the Lord desires. This was the case for Mishael and Elzaphan. These two men were the sons of Moses' and Aaron's uncle Uzziel, making them first cousins of Israel's two primary leaders. Under the law, anyone who touched a corpse became ceremonially unclean for 7 days. For Aaron and his two sons remaining, this would mean being unable to perform their priestly duties during that time. Therefore, Moses called on his relatives who were not from the priestly family to come and remove the bodies of Nadab and Abihu from the sanctuary and bury them outside the camp. So what we're seeing here, what I call a measure of order, and to be able to identify all of the very important intricacies of serving in the Lord, serving in the temple, serving in the priesthood. So we know, and we just learned, because the Sunday school book just told us, that if Aaron and his sons, who are the priests, and designated by God as the priests, if they would have performed their normal duties for their two dead sons, that would have made them, as our Sunday school lesson reminds us, unclean. Anyone who touches a dead body is unclean for 7 days. And so that would have taken Aaron and his two sons out of serving in their priestly duties. So what Moses did, Moses called the sons of Uzziel, the uncle of Aaron and Moses, Mishael and Elzaphan, and they carried out the brethren from the sanctuary out of the camp. Now, understandably, nobody wants to carry a dead body. Understandably, nobody wants to prepare a dead body for the ritual sacrifice and all those things, but here we see that Elzaphan and Mishael were called and that they were obedient. They responded immediately and they took care of the situation. And so when our Sunday school lesson reminds us that God often calls us to do things that are unappealing, unappreciated, unnoticed, and emotionally difficult, we see it here. In the life of Aaron and his sons, in the life of Moses, and even in Mishael and Elzaphan, the sons of Uzziel, the uncle of Aaron and Moses. And I want us to hold on to that, because it's so easy. We're so pampered and we're so comfortable. It's so easy for us to cry, not fair, or cry, this is wrong, or, you know, instead of trying to understand the whole picture of God's divine will and purpose. And so let's see what our Sunday school lesson is sharing with us about verse 5. The Sunday school book says our devotion to the Lord is proved by our faithful, obedient service to Him. We should consider it a privilege to do anything God calls us to do, regardless of how demeaning others may consider it. What area of ministry has God called you into? That's the question. You may not think that what you're doing is very significant, but if God gave you the assignment you have, then it is worthwhile and a valuable means of honoring the Lord, no matter what anyone else may think. When Moses called on Mishael and Elzaphan to remove the dead bodies of Nadab and Abihu, they simply came forward and did what was expected of them. There was no protest or complaint on their part, and there was certainly no applause from others. This was a very somber occasion that required someone to simply step up and do what's needed to be done. I love this lesson this morning because it talks about sacrifice. I love this lesson this morning because it shows us the right order of things, the right way to handle things, the right way to be and to think and to do. That's why this lesson this morning is enriching. The Sunday school lesson says times of tragedy call for faithful people to step up and serve. With the sudden deaths of two of Israel's first priests, the people were undoubtedly in shock. Priests would naturally be considered the holiest people in the community. So to see two of them killed instantly was unsettling, to say the least. Their remains had to be removed, so this was a very important job, even if it was not one that likely would have garnered many volunteers. While we do not want to overstate the importance of what Mishael and Elzaphan did, we do not want to overlook it either. That's what the Sunday school book says. The work they did received very little attention in commentaries, but removing the bodies of these two fallen priests was extremely significant at the time. That the two men obeyed when called on and is worth mentioning, and there's something we can learn from their examples. So our Sunday school lesson reminds us specifically about Mishael and Elzaphan. The two men, our Sunday school lesson says, obeyed when called on, and there is something we can learn from their example. When we read the account of things like this, what I will say is that, one, it's important to be discerning, and two, it's important to be led by the Spirit. If you're in a situation where the divine presence of God is active and moving, if you're in what I call the place where you're standing on holy ground, let the Holy Spirit lead you. And when you let the Holy Spirit lead you to move, to speak, to do, you can't go wrong. Just don't want to be out of order in God. You don't want to be out of order in the things of God. And so it's important to move when the Lord tells you to move. It's important to obey. And so with that, let us continue to read in our scripture this morning. Leviticus chapter 10, verses 6 and 7. Leviticus 10, verse 6 reads, "And Moses said unto Aaron, and unto Eleazar, and unto Ithamar, his sons, uncover not your heads, neither rend your clothes, lest ye die, lest wrath come upon all the people. Let your brethren, the whole house of Israel, bewail the burning which the Lord hath kindled." Verse 7, "And ye shall not go out from the door of the tabernacle of the congregation, lest ye die. For the anointing oil of the Lord is upon you, And they did according to the word of Moses. So what the Lord is sharing with us this morning about these verses is that because of the position that Aaron held, and because of the position of his sons, Aaron's sons, Eleazar and Ithamar, they could not uncover their heads. They could not rend their clothing. Here Moses is saying, lest they die or the wrath come upon all the people. And Moses is encouraging them, let the whole house of Israel mourn the death of Aaron's sons. Moses is instructing them that they cannot go out from the door of the tabernacle of the congregation, or they may die, because the anointing oil of the Lord is upon them. And in this instance, we're showing, being shown through God's word, divine obedience. They did according to the word of Moses. So let's see what our Sunday school book shares with us about verses 6 and 7. The Sunday school book reads, as we have seen, God's call on those who follow him is seldom easy, and at times it is quite difficult. This was especially true for Aaron in this situation, as he was not allowed to publicly grieve the loss of his sons. Any complaint on his part would have been considered further rebellion against the righteousness of God. Any type of public mourning would have actually shown sympathy to those who rebelled against God and incurred his just wrath. How agonizing it must have been for Aaron on the worst day of his life to not be able to mourn the death of his sons. To do so may have given the impression that God was wrong in bringing about the deaths of the two rebellious priests, and this would have invited further wrath. Nothing, not even what we might see as understandable grieving on the part of a heartbroken father, was an excuse for challenging God's holiness. I want to read that again, because I want to make sure we are discerning. I want to make sure that we have a full and complete understanding. Nothing, not even what we might see as understandable grieving on the part of a heartbroken father, was an excuse for challenging God's holiness. What I want to say there is that we have to be discerning. We don't want to challenge God's holiness. We don't want to let our feelings, our emotions get ahead of us or get us into trouble. But we want to be led by the Spirit of God. We want to be led of the Lord. And sometimes it calls us to do as Aaron. Not issue an excuse, not challenge God's holiness because of our ignorance, because of our emotions, because of what we've been through, because of what just happened to us. I want that to be clear. We want to walk with God. We want to be in the center of God's divine will, even when we don't understand, even when it hurts us. This is how we mature in God. This is how we mature in our walk and our relationship with the Lord. And again, I'm talking about God. I'm not telling you to let people mistreat you and walk all over you. It's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about your walk and your relationship with God. I'm talking about challenging God's holiness. People ain't got nothing to do with God's holiness. Being able to recognize that and discern that and let the Spirit of the Lord God lead you and guide you in all things, in every area. So, our Sunday school book says, so some may be asking whether this means Is it wrong to publicly grieve the loss of a loved one today? The answer is an emphatic no. That's what our Sunday school book says. Grieving the death of someone close to us is natural and is to be expected. God in no way will punish anyone for mourning a death. In this instance, and it has to be clear for us, the Sunday school book says, in this instance, however, the Lord was establishing a new nation. He had called out of Egyptian bondage to be a people separated from the world to himself. So we have clearer insight. I'm going to read that again. The Lord was establishing a new nation. He had called out of Egyptian bondage to be a people separated from the world to himself. When you understand the dynamics of what our Sunday school lesson is sharing with us, God's chosen people were called out of, as the Sunday school book says, Egyptian bondage. So in Egypt, they were accustomed to Egyptian ways that were unrighteous, that were unholy, that were not kosher. So they picked up bad habits, bad thinking, bad natures, bad behaviors, bad ways. And so the Lord had to make it very, very clear. And so that's what the Lord is helping us to see and to experience this morning, because it applies to us today, right now in our walk and our relationship with the Lord. And being discerning and mature enough in God and mature enough in the things of God to know. So the Sunday school book says the people of Israel needed to understand that God is uncompromisingly holy in his very nature. I'm going to read that again. The people of Israel needed to understand that God is uncompromisingly holy in his very nature. This meant that in times of extreme difficulty and hardship, they had to persevere in faith and obedience regardless of the circumstances. God was not unsympathetic to Aaron, but Aaron had to demonstrate the importance of revering God regardless of personal struggles and loss. Those who serve the Lord as spiritual leaders and teachers bear great accountability to God. They are entrusted with great responsibility, but given the indwelling Holy Spirit to empower them to live differently from those around them and be examples to God's people. Since Aaron and his surviving sons had been anointed with the oil of the Lord again, a picture of the Holy Spirit as Israel's priest, they were not able to join the rest of the people in mourning. The people had just endured a terrible tragedy. But the work of the high priest, Aaron, and the priests, his two living sons, Eleazar and Ithamar, could not be laid aside. They still had priestly duties that had to be conducted. The work of the Lord was not going to stop because of two rebellious priests, Nadab and Abihu. The remaining priests, Eleazar and Ithamar, were still under the anointing of God and had to conduct themselves accordingly. It must be noted here that although the command that prevented Aaron from publicly mourning his sons and that commanded him to continue to serve as priest between God and the people was grueling from a human standpoint, the anointing of the Lord was still on Aaron. In other words, God was still with Aaron. The anointing had not left. God knew Aaron would not be able to continue on his own. And the Lord never abandoned him. God may call us, the Sunday school lesson reads, to an arduous task, but he will equip and empower us for whatever service he calls us to. He will not leave us alone, even in the midst of the worst tragedies of life. I want to read that again. He will not leave us alone, even in the midst of the worst tragedies of life. He will be with us. As such, God expects us to be diligent in service and faithful to Him at all times. Nadab and Abihu failed to respect the holiness of God. They tried to worship Him the way they wanted, and it cost them their lives. As followers of Jesus Christ, we are His servants. It is essential that we serve Him humbly, yielding always to His authority. God is holy and is to be treated as such. This is another lesson we glean from Robert Ferguson Jr. and really enriching, but this is also an eye-opening study. This is an eye-opening lesson that we get it right, that we work to get it right before God, and that we don't come before God any kind of way. Our motives are pure, our thoughts are pure, our heart is pure, our actions are pure, because God knows the heart. And so that takes us into our photos. I always like to get some eye candy. So what we have here, we have a depiction, of course, of Moses here on the left. Right here we have Moses. And then we have a depiction of Nadab and Abihu offering strange fire to the Lord. And then we have a depiction of Aaron, the high priest, who held his peace, the scripture says, who did not speak a word, who was not allowed to mourn the death of his two rebellious sons, as the rest of the congregation did. He stood and maintained his rightful place in God. The anointing of the Lord was with him and his two remaining sons, Eleazar and Ithamar. I thank God this morning for Sunday school hour. I thank Him for this lesson. There was a number of points that we can take and apply to our life. And so that brings us to our questions this morning. Did we really glean and understand what we were supposed to from our scripture reading? From our Sunday school lesson. So the first question is, what was unacceptable about the fire that the two sons of Aaron brought before the Lord? The second question, what did Moses immediately tell Aaron after the death of his two sons? The third question, how did Aaron respond to Moses' words? The fourth question, who did Moses call on to remove the corpses of Nadab and Abihu, and why did he choose these men? Five, what was Aaron forbidden to do under these circumstances? Question six, is it improper to grieve the death of a loved one? Explain. Number seven, what was God teaching through the limits on Aaron and his sons? Number eight, why could Aaron, Eleazar, and Ithamar not leave the temple? Number nine, what did the anointing of Aaron and his sons indicate? And our last question, number 10, what lessons does this incident have for us this morning? I thank God. This lesson really is enriching and empowering as well. It causes us to work to get it right before God in all areas, in every circumstance and situation. So the answer to our first question, what was unacceptable about the fire that the two sons of Aaron brought before the Lord? The answer is the fire was unacceptable because it was a strange fire brought before the Lord. And we read that in Leviticus chapter 10, verse 1. Leviticus 10, verse 1 says, and Nadab and Abihu, the sons of Aaron, took either of them his censer and put fire therein and put incense thereon and offered strange fire before the Lord, which he commanded them not. And so that takes us to question number two. What did Moses immediately tell Aaron after the deaths of his two sons? The answer is This is it that the Lord spake. I will be sanctified in them that come nigh me. And before all the people, I will be glorified. And we read that in Leviticus chapter 10, verse 3. And it reads, then Moses said unto Aaron, this is it that the Lord spake, saying, I will be sanctified in them that come nigh me. And before all the people, I will be glorified. And Aaron held his peace. And so that takes us to question number three. Question number three says, how did Aaron respond to Moses' words? The answer is, the scripture says, Aaron held his peace, Leviticus 10:3. Question number four, who did Moses call on to remove the corpses of Nadab and Abihu, and why did he choose these men? The answer to number four is, Moses called Mishael and Elzaphan, those are the sons of their uncle Uzziah, to remove the bodies. So now we understand that it was their uncle Uzziel's sons who removed the corpses. All right, so that takes us to question number five. What was Aaron forbidden to do under these circumstances? The answer is Aaron was forbidden to publicly grieve and mourn the death of his two sons. And we can read that on page 11. Question number six says, is it improper to grieve the death of a loved one? Explain. It is not improper to grieve the death of a loved one because it is natural and to be expected. Question number seven, what was God teaching through the limits on Aaron and his sons? God was teaching reverence and obedience and fear through the limits on Aaron and his sons. Question number eight says, why could Aaron, Eleazar, and Ithamar not leave the tabernacle? Aaron, Eleazar, and Ithamar, the answer is, cannot leave the tabernacle because the oil of the anointing was upon them. You can read that on page 12. Question number nine, what did the anointing of Aaron and his sons indicate? The answer is, the anointing of Aaron and his sons indicates sanctification unto God, a picture of the Holy Spirit on them. And you can read about that on page 12. And then our last and final question, question 10, what lessons does this incident have for us? Now, of course, each of us will have a different response, but I took the liberty to write down just a few things that may come to mind. First, this incident has several lessons. God is uncompromisingly holy. We are to follow God, and following God is seldom an easy task. Another lesson is that it's important for us to reverence God regardless of personal loss and struggle. And the list goes on. And I put that because each of us, from the reading of God's word this morning and from the account of what happened to Nadab and Abihu, we will all have different experiences. We will all have a different insight from what the Lord is ministering this morning through our Sunday school lesson. And so that covers us for our questions. We want to make sure that we were able to cover all of our lesson outline this morning. So we were able to read and study about, give me just one second. Okay, all right, so I am back. So, just to recap, I had to catch us up. I didn't fix the slide last night. So just to recap, the fire of the Lord, we were able to read about that, Leviticus chapter 10, verses 1 through 3. Our service to the Lord, we were able to read about that in Leviticus 10, verses 4 and 5. And then the call of the Lord, we were able to read about that in Leviticus 10, verse 6 and 7. So 1 through 3 shows us that when we are in position as high priest, that we can't offer strange fire. We have to get it right and be right before the Lord. And the only way to do that is to keep our hand in the Master's hand. Our service to the Lord reminds us that because of the position that we hold, because of the things of God and there being a certain order, a certain requirement of how things are supposed to flow, sometimes we're called to do things that we don't want to do or things that may be unpleasant, but we're called to step up and take care of what is supposed to be taken care of in that instance at that moment. And of course, it's because we are to be led of God, and we're supposed to be led and discerning and allow the Holy Spirit to lead us. And then finally, the call of the Lord. The call of the Lord sometimes doesn't allow us to step down from the anointing of God. And sometimes it calls us to do and experience the most difficult things, like Aaron and his sons. They weren't able to mourn because the call of God still rested upon them. The anointing, the oil of God was still with them. And so they had to continue in their priestly obligation and priestly duties. And so when we recap our Sunday school hour, when we recap our lesson this morning, the fire of the Lord, we recognize that. Our service to the Lord, we recognize that. The call of the Lord, we recognize that. And as we mature in God and as we mature in the things of God, there will be some things that we may encounter. It may not be to this magnitude that we experienced with Aaron and his sons, but being sensitive and mature enough to handle what the Lord has entrusted to you and allowing the Lord to lead, guide, and direct you is of great importance. And so, takes us to our announcements for the week. Of course, every Thursday evening at 7:30, we have our midweek Bible study. Our Youth Friday will be on Friday, October 1st at 6 p.m. And then our end-of-month service will be this Sunday at 11:30 a.m. What that means is we'll have our Sunday school hour at 10 a.m. Directly after that, we'll go into our end-of-month worship. And again, thank you for being a part of Life in Christ International Church. Thank you for being a part of our Sunday school hour. I pray that this lesson really touched your heart. And not to condemn or cause you to fear and stop reaching for God and reaching for the things of God, but to show you the right way to do things and to reveal to you how things are supposed to be done and let you know that God is right there with you. He wants you to reach for Him. He wants to have an enriched relationship and walk with you. And so with that being said, let us go ahead and close with a word of prayer. And Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you now, God. We thank you for our Sunday school hour. We thank you again, Father, for Life in Christ International Church. We thank you for this lesson and all that we gleaned about service of the Lord and our call in the Lord and the responsibility and the task in which you've placed before us. Father, we honor you, God. And we bless you wholeheartedly, Father. We ask that you would continue to lead us and guide us and direct us. We pray, Father, that as we leave, Father, from our Sunday school hour, but never, ever from your presence, go before us, O God, in all things. Dispatch your angels to encamp your angels about us, O dear God, on every hand, on every side, in every area. Continue to keep us covered in your blood. Continue to cover our families, O God. Continue to cover the church and the church ministries. All of these things we bring before you now, God, in Jesus' name. We love you, Lord, and we bless you and we praise you. Amen, amen. We'll see you back here Thursday evening at 7:30 for our midweek Bible study. Bless God. You all have a blessed rest of your week.